What is femoral neck fracture?
Femur bone is one of the most important bones in our body. This is the largest and the biggest and the strongest bone in the body. The femur bone is also known as thigh bone. So this is the thigh bone. This is the thigh bone. We can see. And it has got three parts. First is the shaft. The topmost part is the head. And the connecting part is the neck of the femur. So this is the strongest bone in the body, and this articulates to form the hip joint, and this is the neck of the femur. Now this femur neck fractures several times with age. This is because of osteoporosis. All the femoral neck fractures are basically low velocity fractures, and these occur because of fall indoors. Person falls inside the house, inside bathroom, and then the fracture can occur. So basically these are all low velocity osteoporotic fractures. So to prevent femoral neck fracture, we have to treat osteoporosis before the fracture occurs. We have to make the bone strong, and there are certain other things that we may need to take care of inside the house, like we should not make the floor slippery, the bathroom should be dry, there should be well lighted, and the femoral neck fracture mostly occurs in senior citizens, so eyesight should be checked regularly, and we should make all arrangements so that they do not fall inside the house. Now, femoral neck fracture is basically a low velocity osteoporotic fracture. What it means is that the senior citizens, the bones become osteoporotic or soft because of lack of calcium. So this leads to a femoral neck fracture. Now this is, as we saw, this is the femur bone. It has got a head, it has got a neck, and it has got a shaft. So the neck of the femur fractures, and that is known as femoral neck fracture. This is basically a osteoporotic fracture, a fracture which has happened because the bone has softened, and mostly it occurs indoors. That means it occurs inside our house. Now this fracture can be anatomically of various types depending on where it has fractured. This is just below the head. It is known as subcapital. This is known as transcervical. This is known as intertrochanteric fracture, and this is subtrochanteric fracture. So this is the various types of fracture that occur based on the anatomy, and the treatment depends on the anatomy where it has fractured. The cause of femoral neck fracture is osteoporosis. Femur neck fractures because of osteoporosis. The bones soften with age. This is a fracture of senior citizens. This is a fracture mostly happens in elderly age group, and most of them fall inside the house. The person would have fallen either in house or in bathroom. Once a femur neck fracture has occurred, the person will not be able to walk, the person will not be able to stand, and the leg will lie helplessly rotated. So the person is not able to walk after a neck femur fracture. Femur neck fracture, the person is not able to walk and becomes bedridden. So with that, there can be multiple complications which include bed sore, chest infection, and other problems. So basically the problem is that the person will not be able to walk, and it will become bedridden after femoral neck fracture. Femur neck fracture is diagnosed clinically when we see that the leg of the person is rotated and it is lying helplessly without any movement. So it is diagnosed clinically. Once it is suspected, we do X-ray. Once we see the X-ray, we can see clearly that the neck of femur has fractured. This is the X-ray. So this is the head of the femur, this is the shaft of the femur, and this is the neck of the femur which has fractured. So it is diagnosed in X-ray. This is one type of fracture. There are other type of fractures which are again seen in X-ray. This is another type of fracture. So this is, we can see that the femur neck has fractured in X-ray. And there are other types, like this is also a type of femoral neck fracture, which is just below the head of the femur. And it can be a trochanteric fracture, where the level of fracture is lower down. So here also in X-ray we can see that this has fractured. The neck of the femur has fractured, and this is known as trochanteric fracture. So this is the fracture which is lower down than what we saw just before. Now, femur neck fracture needs surgery. It has to be operated. Now, there are two kinds of operation. First is fixation. We can see in this chart. This is the first method. Depending, all the treatment methods depend on what is the type of fracture and when it has been brought to us. So, the first is we fix with multiple screws. This is applicable when the fracture is high up. It is applicable when the fracture is high up. This is known as cancellous screws and it is fixed. If the fracture is lower down, then it is fixed with something called dynamic hip screw. It has got a plate and a big screw which goes inside the head. So this is one method of fixation. And if the fracture is old, what it means is that it has been brought after a few days. Then when we find that the bones are very soft and the fracture is old, it is less likely to unite. Then we replace it with the femoral head is replaced by a prosthesis, which is which can be hemiarthroplasty or hip half hip replacement, or it can be total hip replacement, total hip arthroplasty. So these are the various treatment options of femoral neck fracture.